The Suunto Spartan Ultra GPS Multisport. It's a mouthful, and in my opinion, the Suunto does deliver the mouthful because it has a lot of functions. It's used for multisport like cycling, running, swimming, but also hiking and just fitnessing. But in my opinion, this is just a brand new watch. It will be again the real fanatical multisport people like me who want to buy this watch. Let's be completely clear, the watch isn't released yet. There are not that many things clear about it, the functions, but a couple of functions are clear, so I will mention them to you and I will show you the different designs, which are pretty in my opinion. So what it does have, as you can see, it has color screen, but what you can't see, it's touch. So you can just touch the screen to use it, but it has also 5 buttons, so 3 on the right side, 2 on the left. The biggest improvement from the Embit, because it's the sequel to the Embit series, which was there for a couple of years, is that it doesn't have a GPS knob which is sticking out of the watch itself. So I like the Embit. I had 2 Embits, but the GPS module was kind of strange because like Garmin and Polar and TomTom and Timex, they did not have those kind of stupid bumps on the product. So that's my opinion about that thing. I think this one is really nice. It looks a little bit like the Moto 360 and also like the new Samsung smartwatch, and I think that's a compliment because Samsung doesn't make good activity trackers, but it makes beautiful activity trackers. And Suunto is, as you perhaps know, one of the best heart rate monitors fabricants. So what it does have, touchscreen, 5 knots, it's watertight, waterproof till 100 meters, so that's enough for the most people. It has activity tracking, and the former Embit did not have that, and that was kind of old-fashioned. And the biggest disadvantage of this watch, this Spartan, is in some people's opinion, I know that for sure, is that it does not have optical heart rate measurement, like a heart rate measurement on your wrist. You have the Garmin 235, the Fenix 3 HR, and you have a couple of TomToms, Mios, Samsungs, a lot of activity trackers and professional heart rate monitors do have the optical heart rate measurement unit on the wrist. There are a lot of discussions about the reliability of that heart rate measurement. If you watch this YouTube channel, you will see lots of heart rate tests. I just make the video while wearing them all together, and you can see in that video that they give different measurements, but they are for the best models not that different, and then it's just a question what is correct. So that's about the heart rate measurement unit. So it has also a little bit of navigation, but that's not quite sure how in-depth that will be. So I tested also the Garmin Epix, and that has, for example, just little maps which you can touch and just zoom in and out. I don't think this Spartan will have that. So navigation is always a little bit it's a little bit marketing, but sometimes it's enough for just simple tracking. So it has a barometer, it has Bluetooth smart, so you can connect it with your phones, and you will use the app. And of course, nowadays with activity tracking all day, and this is beautiful watch, so you will wear it all day, you can just measure all your activities. And then you have to use an app, of course, because you want to see it, you want to analyze it, and not only on the watch, but also on the phone and later on perhaps on your laptop. So that's it about the Suunto Spartan. I will buy it as soon as possible, and I will be back then. Perhaps you can see this video here in this YouTube channel, and then you can perhaps already see the in-depth test of the product. Thanks and bye.